Hey Internet, my name is Abby and welcome back to Buzz Aldrin Space Program Manager. After the very disappointing ending of the last episode, I'd like to try this time something different. But, well, I'm still a little bit, or I'm really disappointed by the last episode because I did everything I needed to do. I completed every necessary goal. I was at the maximum R&D level. I trained up my employees. I did everything I needed to do. And the chances of success were close to 90%. But yeah, it was a catastrophic outcome. I don't know, I think at some point this game really says, okay, Zebby, you are not allowed to show your viewers a successful moon landing. We have to screw it up anyways. So yeah, I don't know. Three failures in a row, this is really hard. But okay, let's look ahead, let's do something different. As I said, I want to do something different, and now I like to see something or a different space center. In this case, I like to play for the NASA side. As I said, I want to demonstrate you also a little bit the Soviet Space Agency, but unless there are the animations implemented, it could be a little bit redundant, because then we only see or mostly see the placeholder images. In this case, I like to go for the NASA side, and we only can play it on the sandbox mode, but I will say, or I will pretend that the long-term objective will exist there. So if I'm not able to land on the moon before the fourth quarter or on the fourth quarter of 1973, then I will just end the game and pretend that I have lost, and otherwise yeah, I won. And so in this case I will do or try to pretend that this is a campaign mode and I have only the time until the fourth quarter of 1973. And in this case, let's start and let's play Bathard as the usual. And so yeah, now we have the bulletin for the NASA news. This is pretty new. And I like the new description. The National Aeronautics and Space Administration, NASA, has been established and its first administrator has been appointed. The administrator will be in charge of managing the agency's budget and ensuring the America becomes a leader in space exploration. Okay, and ensuring America becomes a leader in space exploration, okay. So yeah, this is pretty cool, and also there are some... Yeah, over here, in the year 1955, the sound barrier has been broken only a few years ago, and the first Earth orbiting satellite has yet to be deployed in a effort of to conquer outer space and make America a key international player in space exploration. The government has established NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. Your duties... no, there is no change, and... Is here a change? No. Okay, there isn't any change. Okay, now we are playing on the NASA side. We can see something different here. We can see a different space center. This is pretty refreshing, I guess. After we have failed so many times, and I don't know, I will start off building right away my astronaut center, and I will build my flight controller center, and I think I will start off with the space plane is risky because I need to train a little bit my astronauts. I think I need to build the VAB right away. I hope I can manage this without having trouble with my costs. And I will upgrade my science building right away, so I'm losing a lot of money at the beginning. And then we want to go to the headquarters and we want to start researching the Explorer 1, our very first satellite. So let me open the Explorer 1, very nice. And then we need... Oh no, we can't open up a rocket program. So in this case, manage payload and R&D. I will start working on the Explorer 1. As I said, the space plane needs some time because I need to train astronauts and so on. In this case, I think I will send one of my scientists right away to advanced training so that he can become a little bit better. And this is Void Whitehead. You will go to advanced training and you can learn crewed spacecraft, because this will be the X-15, so you can get a little bit better in this thing. So okay, now let's end the season. And the Explorer 1 makes some good progress, this is amazing. Explorer 1 has opened, and yeah, the new mill. And when we are going over to the public office, we see we don't have any goals, but we still pretend. We only have time until the fourth quarter of 1973. And here, okay, we now can hire some flight controllers. Let me do this right away. Oh, you are pretty good in trajectory, so I'd like to have you right away. Propulsion 59. This one, and then I'd like to have spacecraft systems 54. Okay, 54 at the best, and spacecraft systems, crew and payload 57. 58, 68, okay. And mission operations, 57. 57, okay. Let's hire these 5 recruits, very good. And back to space complex, and here, let's end the season. Okay. 54 for the explorer, very nice. And we have hired some flight controllers, and we will increase a little bit the R&D, and we have built our VAB. Unfortunately, we can't enter it, and we have also finished the building of our astronaut center. This is very nice. And what about my fundings? I'm still getting some money. This is good. So let me hire very young astronauts who can stick with me through the whole space program. Okay, 25 is the youngest age. Leadership 46, 60. And 44, okay, so I like to have the 61, 60, and the 46. Let's hire these 2 recruits, yes, thank you so much. Back to space complex, and we can also hire 3 new scientists. I like to have crewed spacecraft, oh, this is amazing. Crewed spacecraft. Crewed spacecraft. I'm mostly looking currently for crewed spacecraft guys. Oh, I just wanted to hire 3. Okay, this is good. Yeah, let's hire them. Very nice. And then we need also a rocket. Let me see. Open rocket program. Oh, do I do a mistake? Because I need Jupiter C booster. It's pretty cheap. Unit cost. We can also go for the Juno booster. I think the unit costs are a little bit more. I think, well, no, I go for the Jupiter C booster. I think this is good enough. How much does the Explorer 1 weight? It's 5 kilograms, okay. And the Juno, yeah, it's good enough. Let me open this program. Oh, this was a little bit early because I don't have scientists yet. But okay, let's move on. Let's end the season. Yeah, I want to end the season. Okay, 65 for the Explorer. Good progress. We have hired some. Oh no, they have graduated from basic training. This is good. Then one of my scientists is back. This is also nice. And we have hired some astronauts. This is everything is very nice. Manage rockets. Okay. I want to start with this. Okay, you are a little bit bad, but this is currently okay. And we have flight controllers. I want to send you to advanced training right away, so that you can become better. Propulsion, for what have I hired you? I think you're my propulsion guy, aren't you? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, you are my propulsion guy, so you can learn a bit more about propulsion. You can learn a bit more about spacecraft systems. You can learn more about crew and payload, and you can learn more about mission operation. Very nice. Very nice. Okay, let's end the season again. Explorer 1 almost ready to go. Jupiter C booster needs a lot of time. Well, I don't have the scientist yet. And okay, 3 new scientists. Very nice. I can add them right away to the rocket booster. So, very good, very good. So now we are making some good progress. And let's end the season. Yeah, I want to do this. Okay, 79 for this one, 31 for this one, very good. And my flight controllers are back from advanced training. This is good. Let's send them back in right away. Trajectory. Propulsion. Spacecraft systems. Crew and payload. And mission operations. Very nice. Back to space complex. And okay, one additional season. Then I think I can reschedule my scientist. Yeah, 83% for the satellite. This is good. And the booster needs some time, but this is okay. And we have hired two astronauts. This is also very nice. At first, I like to reassign my flight controllers. You can step away from this project at first. And then we can see if someone is better. 33%. Of course, we have someone who's better there. 55. 58? No, 53, okay. Oh, but better than... Okay, now we have the best guys working on this project. And now I can... Hopefully we have enough money to do this. I can start the X-15. Let me do this. Yeah, the cost... Well, okay, then we are still making some money. This is good. The maintenance cost for this project, and now we have the killer. We have opened up the killer project, the nightmare project, the X-15, and now let's assign some scientists to it so that they can start working on the X-15, and they will have at least 4 seasons time, because I will send my astronauts right away to advanced training so that they can become better in their skills. And so this will take 4 seasons. In this case, we have 4 seasons time to develop the X-15. And now let's proceed on. The Jupiter Sea Booster, 61%, very nice. Oh, the X-15 makes very, very fast progress. And my flight controllers are back from advanced training, but I think I send them right away back in there, because the Jupiter Sea Booster needs some time. In this case, I can train up a little bit more my flight controllers so that they are well prepared for the upcoming duties, like the X-15 flight and the mission launch. And okay, let's end the season again. 69, year as expected, 59, very nice. No new news, also as expected. And end the season right away. 77, okay, and 73. And my flight controllers should be back. Yeah, they are back. And what is this? The last season surprise health and safety executives inspection required a costly update of all your present facilities, which ended up in costing 737. Okay, this is okay. And now it's up to us to do the very first launch. We want to launch our Explorer 1. We want to do this. And we want to use our Jupiter Sea Booster. Assemble it. Start the assembly process, and booster, spacecraft system, and flight director. Very good. Booster, I thought, why are you so bad? And wait, let me remove you. Yeah, Paul Richardson is better in boosters, so why have you assigned him to the flight director? This is strange. This was not good. This was not a good decision. And the other two guys, the other two flight controllers, can go to advanced training. You can learn a bit more about trajectory. And who is available? You can learn more about crew and payload. Okay. Yeah, this is good. This wraps up for the season. Let's end the season and let's move on. 81%. Very nice. 81% for the X-15. And what? Prestige and from success, 1,650. This is a high amount. Okay, followed from the mission control. We want to see the X-15, not the X-15. We want to see the Explorer 1 being launched on top of the Jupiter Sea Booster. Okay, it's a success. Very nice, very nice. And countdown. Also success, very good. And here we go, launch. The launch was also a success, very nice. Good job, guys. Let's ascend up into space. Let's send our very first satellite into space. Satellite deployment. Okay, it was a success. Very nice. Very, very nice. And we are in Earth orbit. Yeah, we are in Earth orbit. Good job, guys. Good job. A successful mission. Amazing. Very nice. And Earth orbiting research satellite. And radio signals emission from low Earth orbit. Study of the Earth's magnetic field. Explorer 1 satellite. Amazing. Good job, guys. Good job. Okay, my astronauts are back from advanced training. This is very good. So, in this case, and we can now do lunar probes and sun probes, but we don't have the money yet to do this. Wait, what do I need for... I need highest prestige. 2500, okay. So I need to have another successful mission. I'm thinking about doing the Nightmare. I'm doing thinking about X-15. Let's schedule the mission. Oh, I need at least 4 flight controllers. Okay, I can't schedule this mission. 2500, okay. How many seasons? 6 seasons, okay. Explorer 1 extended configuration. How much prestige I will get from you? 500. Oh, this is a nice number. Let's do the extended mission. Let's schedule the mission. Start the assembly process. And I will do this manually, or you would assign again the wrong persons to this. Okay, confirm the assignment. Very good. And yeah, my astronauts, this... How many seasons is this? I'm so scatter-minded. The extended duration, flight controllers, how many seasons? Can I see this somewhere? Number of season 3. Okay, in this case, I can send my astronauts back to advanced training, or this would be a waste of their capabilities, so you can learn more about leadership. You can also train your leadership. Very good, very good. Back to space complex. And end the season. Okay. The booster makes good progress. The X-15 makes good progress. Very nice. And let's launch the mission. Yeah, I want to monitor this. And let's see the launch preparations. I hope we won't have any issues. Okay, countdown. Countdown. Was a success. Very nice, very nice. And here goes the launch. Here goes our rocket up into space. Very nice, very nice. And we have a problem. Chances of success 76% and problem solved. Whew, this was close. This was really close. But compared to my lunar attempt, I need to mention this again, because I am really annoyed by this. There I had about 90% and I had a catastrophic outcome. And in this case, here with measly 76%, we have a success. Why? Honestly, why? Why, game? Why are you doing this to me? Why do you have to fail me all the time? This is not fair. This was really not fair. Okay, Earth orbit. The first step was a success. Very nice. Good job, guys. Good job. And come on. And my flight controllers are back from advanced training. Very nice. And we have still our mission going on. Let me just send you again to advanced training so that you can learn a bit more about trajectory and you can learn more about crew and payload. Very good, very good. And end the season. Yeah, I want to end the current season. And proceed on. And resume the mission. And follow it from the mission control, of course. And are we still in Earth orbit? And can we still do our advanced experiments? I hope so. Yeah, we can. Good job. Another 100 points earned for this step. This is amazing. Very good, very good. Okay. And... this mission is still going on, so let's do this. Let's continue. Yeah, I want to end the mission. or the season, and wow, the X-15 is at 90%, this is very good. So let's resume the mission and let's see, can we do our advanced experiments in Earth orbit? Can we continue with it? Yeah, we can. It was a success. Amazing. 250 prestige points earned. Amazing. Good job, guys. Very nice. But unfortunately, we haven't received any goals because there weren't no goals to achieve. It was a successful mission, and my flight controls have graduated from advanced training. This is nice. The Jupiter C booster has maximum R&D level. Due to recent successes, the members of the SAT personnel group have increased their morale by 17%. This is very nice. And now I have some free scientists, but at first, manage programs. I don't need the Explorer 1 anymore. Let me close this program. Yeah, I want to close this. What does an X-15 launch cost? Let me see this. This would cost 715, okay. And back to space, what does advanced training session cost? Advanced training session, for crewed spacecraft maybe? 50. Okay, this is good. You can learn a bit more about also crewed spacecraft. Assigned, available. You can learn more about human-rated rockets. Assigned, available. You can learn more about also human-rated rockets. Okay, very good. My flight controllers are back. I won't send them to advanced training because in the next season my astronaut should be finished with their training and then I can do the X-15 flight. Okay, 91%, and yeah, my astronauts are back. This is very nice. Oh, increased public interest in your program has given you a boost of 494 prestige points. So we have reached the maximum prestige, this is good, but I still like to do the X-15 flight. So, space plane, X-15, flight test, schedule, yeah, assemble now, start the assembly process with the best candidates, and yeah, okay, this looks really nice. Confirm the assignment, our pilot is Jemmer Gosshard. Confirm the assignment, okay, very good. But if the thing is again a nightmare or not, we will find out in the next episode. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked this. I hope you will be joining me in the next episode. Until then, my name is Zebby. See you!